Soviet couple on their way up, trying to fight their way into a medal position. They were fourth in the World Championships last year, their fourth gear, coming to the second compulsory dance. Natalia Anenko and Genrik Slepensky.
Dance really can to a certain degree be related to the entrance in the bull ring. For example, these moves right here, progressive, the entrance into the bull ring, the sighting of the bull. Then the second section, a respite. And then this, another charge. And finally, the pass with the cape when she makes a turn in that last dance step.
Anenko and Stradensky of the Soviet Union. Partners for 5 years. It's taken a long way to fight their way towards the medal position in international competition.
Well, they're really quite wonderful. They have great, great elegance and style. Look at it here. It's marvelous, you know. They're really wonderful.
They are standing by for their marks.
You know, by describing this as a bullfight and a man with his cape, I'm talking about the Paso Doble itself. This is a compulsory dance. And of course...
Winter Games.
After any great event in your life, win or lose is usually a kind of a restless time. We wondered how Brian Boitano and Brian Orser felt after their memorable battle of last evening in the Olympic Saddle Dome. First, let's check in with Brian Boitano with Donna De Verona in the Olympic Village.
With me is America's gold medalist, Brian Boitano, and everybody wants to see you, but they're not going to get to hear you, are they?
No, not tonight.
All the tension, you think, and all the excitement, maybe... helped you lose your voice?
I think I haven't gotten too much sleep and all the interviews.
Linda, did you ever expect this kind of response? I know you planned for it, but you don't ever plan as an Olympic athlete or a coach with what comes after a gold medal victory.
I think